This is our land where we live.
And our ancestors have been living.
They have been buried here. How you destroy them? And here in this forest, we have different celebrations. In the rainy season, we celebrate this side. In the summer, we celebrate this side. So entire area is a place of celebration. So this way, they answered, and judge did not know how to respond to it. So they beautifully they expressed their opinion, their feelings, their sentiments, and finally, the Supreme Court respected the people's sentiments and their opinion, and finally the company had to leave the place, and the people are still in the forest. So, and there how my role was here to convince the people. Sometimes they could have been very violent way of dealing with this situation. As a students of philosophy and theology, and of course as a lawyer, knowing the constitution and different provisions of the country, I taught this smallite. This is the same like the pesite, smallite like this. So I went and I told them, this is your rights, so you can speak based on this small law, you can speak about your rights to the judges and all. So this way how I went on convincing the people, and they responded so well. And then it was very peaceful and very amicable agreement or acceptance by all. So that way how I was feeling, this is how when I learned Gandhi, or I learned Jesus, or I learned Buddha, how we can deal with the different conflict situation and we can establish peace and harmony. And that's how I love to say, the tribal people, they have this type of values, no? Caring, sharing, and community living. They care for one another. They share whatever they have. Even they share their foods and grains with the animals, which was very strange to see when I went to that forest. So that's how I feel that Gandhi is teaching the same values, and also in Christian literature or in Christian prayer, there is a term, the kingdom of God. This term is there, which is justice, peace, and equality. It's all entire brotherhood and sisterhood that we are living in this earth. So I think when we really understand all these things, and Gandhiji tried to live and to make entire community, entire country to live with this type of values, I think that was great. And we need to revisit Gandhi and understand him. And that's all. He used to give this type of big messages to the public in the country, which was a great thing. And at this present moment, I feel in the country, in our India, not only in India, this type of conflicts are going on all over the world. Maybe when I saw, and I was talking to some of the indigenous people here just now, few hours back, I was also thinking they have gone through this type of process. So, but now the elder was talking, all of us are one human beings, like that he spoke. Everybody has got hearts, this way how he's speaking. So I was taken up with the thoughts that they had for everyone. So that's beautiful. And Gandhi also was speaking that way. I think we need to revisit Gandhi and a global efforts and collaboration for peace and harmony in the entire world is needed. No matter we are Indian or Canadian or wherever we are, but in the world, this is the call of the present day. And Gandhi's non-violent movement is definitely, other speakers will speak. And King Martin Luther's movement also we are knowing it. And therefore, this type of movements are very inspirational thoughts for us to pick them up. And to the last line, the Mother Earth and well-being of all, that is, one is Mother Earth is the concept of the indigenous people, I think. Always we call Mother Earth, you know, all the animals and fish, their brothers and sisters, trees are our sisters. This type of sentiments we have. Well-being of all, it is our from Gita, our Indian holy book Gita, from that Sarve Sukhena Bhavantu, this way how we call. So how that beautiful thoughts we have, and suppose we, with this type of thoughts, we go to the whole world, I think the world also could realize this type of peace and harmony, and all of us could live in harmony. Thank you very much for.
Next, Dr. William Bhaskaran will speak to us. Shanti Sena.
Good afternoon, everybody. I thank a few of you to make a small presentation because the area given is so vast, but I try to make it very brief for the sake of every one of us. I was asked to speak on peace drinking. This is an experiment we have been doing it in our university. And this is a concept given by Gandhi. Particularly, I strongly believe that this will be more relevant today. As you know, this world is passing through the kind of polarization and acute conflict, where you could see a lot of violence among human beings. And how to face this issue of violence and conflict, that's a great concern. Though on the one side, we have been developing ourselves with infrastructures and facilities, with the huge economy and everything. But handling human conflict still has to grow, you know. And Gandhi made a proposal to people to consider. It's called Shanti Sena. This concept he developed when he faced the Hindu Muslim conflict in India. When he saw it, how to deal with it, can police and army to deal with it. And Gandhi had his own reservations. And he wanted people initiated to deal with these kinds of issues. Therefore, he developed this idea and presented before us. And what is Shanti Sena? It's called a peace brigade, or nonviolent corps, or peace army. And Gandhi used a different terminology at a different point of time to explain his ideas. But he tried to mean one thing, trying to people who could work for peace, who could help people to solve the problem of communism and to solve the problem of other issues and conflicts which threaten their coexistence. So Gandhi visualized conflict, Shanti Sena, in the context of conflict resolution, I would say. Because his main idea was to bring in these two communities together. And whenever there's a clash, and he wanted to try the people to intervene and resolve conflict. That's the main idea of Shanti Sena. And the second important idea is to build peace. Building peace and transforming the conflict. That's an idea. And how to build peace. And he gave another equal, another idea, everything. He took it all together. That's called constructive program. And to construct the society based on certain important values of truth and nonviolence. So that was his main idea of that. So peace building. And he said, Shanti Sainiks will do this work when there is no conflict. So these people will work in the villages, in the towns, and bring peace between communities and people. And this kind of peace building activities is visualized. The third thing is, in the case of invasion, it's a very big concept. You know that civilian defense, you would have heard about it. That he gave, and particularly when Japanese tried to occupy capture India. And he gave this idea. He said, and the Indians should ready to resist the invading army. And that has to be coordinated by Shanti Sainiks, of course, he made a proposal in front of Congress to consider this. Somehow it was not materialized for various reasons, and his request was declined. But he was said that on your own, if you want to pursue, I think we don't stop. So he asked Mirab, that one of his disciples, to go to that region to organize people to resist them. And that was part of Shanti Sena. And then when he explained Shanti Sena concept, he said, you know, other people, other forces, maybe military or police, they appear to the scene when the conflict breaks out. And they are trying to handle or control or contain the conflict. Now, we need the force, and more not using much intelligence as we use it today. And who could understand the emergence of conflict and the intervene?